forgotten where we came from. We have forgotten who we are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious. We will become strong. We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear. No longer hunt for our food, search for our water, or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring out our best. War will bring us life. Ancient men were killers. They were tenacious. They were strong. Now what are we? Passive.
Back up, on its way!
ancient man were killers. They were tenacious. They were strong. Now what are we? Passive, lazy, weak. Culture and technology hasn't improved us, it's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors...
Over here!
I'm just glad to see it out of the cult's hands, training those wolves to cause hell.
and they've been shipping those crazy wolves all the way to the old lumber mill. Keep an eye on prisoners. Now, we had a bear here named Cheeseburger, bit of a local celebrity, actually. Had a soft spot for Chad's barbecue, but he got the diabetes, so we put him on a liquid salmon diet. Anywho, Colt tried to take him, so I set him free. Last I heard, he was causing all sorts of mayhem. Someone should go find him, make sure he's all right. Grab some salmon from the pond ahead of time, though. Then feed Cheeseburger that salmon, and he'll be eating out of the palm of your hand.
Hey, if you got that salmon, I just heard Cheeseburger was spotted at Lanero Building Supplies. Don't be shy or anything. Just get right up in there and give them the salmon. Cuddly little guy will eat it right out of your hand, don't you worry.
He's a slippery one, that's for sure. They want you to be strong.
One of you will be strong.
Not again.
Get out of here, Peaches.
The only one to be tested.
Did you know that I had a wife?
So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were going to work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take her. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong. Because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. When all she had in the world was me. A nobody from nowhere with nothing. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head. And I leaned in and I could smell. And we prayed together. Prayed for wisdom. Prayed for strength. And I knew. I heard God's plan for me. I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped to her angelic face, and I pinched it shut. And after a little while, her legs began to kick and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth and the Lord take. Pain, sacrifice, these are all part of his test. And we have to prove that we can serve God no matter what he asks. You've done well.
Sacrifice the weak. That's it. is gonna last for as long as you...
Good to see you, Depp.
You never have enough ammonia.
Got a job for you. You remember the Grandview Hotel? That shithole we pulled you out of? Need you to head back there. Jacob nabbed a whitetail by the name of Briggs, and he's using the same brain-melting nonsense he tried on you. All in the hopes that Briggs will give up the wolf's den. I don't think our boy can hold out as long as you did. And if he gives up our location, we're done. So we gotta move on this quick. Some folks here think the smart move would be just to off him. But if we start killing our own to save our asses, how's that make us any better than Jacob? Nah, I ain't going down that road. Here's what we're gonna do instead. Weedy's cooked up a little deprogramming package. Same thing we used on you. Need you to swap out the tape they got running in Briggs' room with the one I'm gonna give you. And then, well, then we'll see what happens. If everything goes smooth, our guy comes back to Earth. If it doesn't, well, we'll deal with that when the time comes.
There. I shouldn't even be here. Oh, shit! You made it back! Good thing I called. That could have been messy, huh? Sorry about that. I should have double-checked before I sent you out. That was my fault. But you did good work. Got enough of the Bliss-infused samples. That's what we needed. I've had time to tweak the formula, and now it's rock solid. As soon as it finishes processing, you'll have a new batch waiting. I can't thank you enough for all you've done around here, Deputy. Sheriff said you were good, but I didn't think you were this good.
That's not true, but it's a nice thought.
Yeah.
If you found him, just let the tape do its thing.
This world seems right.
Ah, shit. I'm seeing trucks headed your way. Jacob must have been waiting for us to hit him again. Kid, I'm seeing mortars and MGs outside. Get creative. They got lots of toys out there.
Come on. that he's still lurking around.
Than a box of shit, ain't ya? I said, get over here! Hey, you're that sumbitch Dutch was going on about. You a registered voter? Nah, don't matter. I need help of a different sort. Let's get to the point. You see that steaming pile of disappointment over there praying? That's my loin fruit, Hurt Jr. Dumber than a coal bucket. He takes after his mama. Stupid sumbitch went and lost my campaign truck, Nancy. So named after the greatest first lady to ever serve this fine country, of course. If them Obama-loving libtards find out I can't look after my own property, I can kiss this Senate run goodbye. Now, seeing as you're on my land, and I didn't kill you, even though it's well within my rights as a red-blooded American gun owner, I say you owe me. Help numbnuts get my truck back so I can start focusing on my campaign again. Junior, someone's here to help you. Try not to fuck it up.
amigos!
I'm sorry, I don't want to go on assuming nobody's gender or nothing. I mean, I don't mean no disrespect. I just call all my homies dude or bro or man, you know, regardless of vagitalia or penile-ness.
Whoa, deja voodoo, man. Have we met before? Dang, man, my prayers have been answered. I got a direct line to that sweet little monkey god whose heart hangs in heaven. Well, I guess since you're an angel working here on Earth, the Monkey King, that you already know I gotta get my daddy's truck back. I mean, he's real butt sore. But if we get it back, he'll let me sleep in my bed again. And I gotta tell you, man, it's getting real cold outside. Never mind them wood ticks crawling all up in my junk, threatening me with Lyme disease and whatnot. So come on, man, help me get my daddy's truck back. Let's make dust before the old man starts shooting. He's hotter than a ghost pepper these days. Santa Run's been real stressful on him, man. He ain't cut out for that shit. You know how busy he is? Doesn't even have time to cut out for a shit. Come on, man, get in.
Oh, if your mother was a screamer and your father ruled with fists.
Shit, man, I've been praying on this all day, man. I've been asking the Monkey King, all the baby Jesuses, even the little Valentine's one, just to send me a sign, man, and they sent me you. I'll tell you something, though, man. Getting that truck, it ain't gonna be easy. Damn cult's got it, man. Well, I'll be honest with you, it all started when I tried to join them. I mean, it just seemed like a good idea. I mean, they had all these guns, food, fine-ass females, and I mean, those are three things I'm really all about. I mean, it seemed like one big party over there. So I says, hey, amigos, where do I sign up? He said, sign up right here, friend. Then they start listing off all their dang rules, man. No fornicating. Turns out that means fucking. No alcohol and no wild out and partying, man. No thank you. So I got the fuck out of there, man. Unfortunately, though, I forgot my daddy's truck. He's been real butt sore since, so I gotta get that truck. You don't gotta worry about a thing, man. I got a 9-step plan to get in this truck back. Step 1, catch a day buzz off party liquor. Got that one covered, homie. Step 2, pray for someone else to solve my problem. Done. Step 3 is... Shit, I forget the rest, but they'll come to me as soon as we go. Dang, you are a good listener, Boba Fett. My old man doesn't listen at all. I guess that's why I never feel hurt. Me and him, we ain't getting along that well lately. Ever since he started running for office, he's been coming down on me real hard about everything. About my public intoxication, how I handle my firearms, stuff like that, man. But when we get his truck back from them Peggy's, he's gonna be real impressed, dude. He's gonna love me so much, and then my mom's gonna have to try and love me more so she can compete with how much he loves me. And then he'll see how much she's loving me, and then he'll try and love me even more, and then birthdays and Christmases, they're gonna be off the chain. All right, man, this is the place.
I listen to Jonah. go whinge on their asses. I like the cut of your chip. You play your cards right, and I might let you in on a little something I've been cooking up.
Save us! Look at all these dead bodies!
We got a jackal in our midst.
Over here. Man, I love the theater.
Don't you worry about me, I'm still here. Okay, man, now it's time for step four. Truck's actually all the way down yonder. Probably more Peggy's waiting for us, too. It's all about the zipline, man. We're gonna zipline in there, sneak up on them like ninjas.
Stealth mode, right? Fuck yeah, man!
Bro!
I'll be honest with you, man. I took my parents' divorce real personal. I know they say it ain't never the kid's fault, but, man, I took it to heart anyway. Ran away from home. Dude, I was terrified. I had just turned 30 years old, and I didn't know what I was doing, man. I mean, there was a thrill that came with being a runaway and a freedom that I cannot explain. I mean, that's where I found myself, and that is why I recommend running away to every child I meet. Jacob still got your buddy Pratt, man. And if war movies have taught me anything, it's that you never leave a buddy outside. Or a guy behind. What came first, the chicken or the egg? Wait. What are we talking about, man? Were we gonna shoot something or?
More show up. Oh, Mayor, we got trouble. Reach into that there cooler. See if we have any cans of whoop ass left. And pass me a beer.
Some thinking while you were gone. This whole Senate run is too much for me to handle on my own. I'm in need of a campaign manager, and you're just the kind of go-getter I need to get my ass in office. First task I got is to take Junior with you wherever you go, so I don't have to hear him praying to that goddamn Monkey King no more. Second task is, let me think on it a bit. I'll get back to you.